mai, haere mai. Nā taku pōtiki kui, e tiki atu I kukuma mai ki te tahatū o te... Nō reira, haere mai. Haere mai runga te karanga o te whare wānanga o Tāmaki Makaurau. Mō tēnei rā whakahirahira mō ngā tauira o te wānanga nei. Ko horahi e te whāriki, ki te ihi, ki te wehi, ki te mana, I runga I te marae o te rā. Nō reira, piki mai, kake mai, haere mai rā.
Please be seated. Ena mana, ena reo, ena hoi whā. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Council members, members of the University, special guests, graduands, families and friends, I extend a warm welcome to this, the fifth autumn graduation ceremony for 2012 of the University of Auckland. This week, the University is bestowing a total of 7,048 qualifications on some 6,862 students. At this ceremony, degrees will be conferred and diplomas awarded in the Faculty of Science. A total of 415 in person, plus a further 305 in absentia. As Chancellor, I am privileged to preside at graduation once more. The twice-yearly cycle of graduation ceremonies makes them no less significant for the University and me personally than for those of you being capped here today, many for the first and only time. Graduation is always a festive event, rich in history, pomp and colour, but with some endearing contemporary touches. Here in Auckland, our enviable mix of cultures and ethnicities is evident in the variety of dress and adornments worn by some graduands. Today is one of celebration, hard-earned and well-deserved, by you, the graduates and diplomates, on your academic feats, and by your family and friends who have encouraged and supported you in good times and in bad, and who are here to rejoice in your success. The University, represented by the Council and academic staff members seated behind me, and those many professional staff who direct proceedings with unerring precision, takes equal satisfaction in your hugely significant day. The University of Auckland is deservedly ranked as one of the best universities in the world. The qualifications bestowed on you today will always serve you well in this country and abroad, whether in qualifying you for a fulfilling career or in leading to further challenging study, or simply for your own personal and intellectual enrichment. In today's world of constant and often bewildering change, you can never afford to stop learning and honing your skills and capabilities. So do keep in mind our ever-expanding range of postgraduate opportunities. The critically important role of major research-led universities in modern life is not always understood. Our cutting-edge research is vital for long-term sustainable economic growth and social development, never more so than in these globally uncertain economic times. Universities such as ours equip graduates like you, not simply for the jobs of today, but for careers not yet imagined. The University of Auckland's aspirations for the period ahead and our responses to an increasingly constrained funding environment are comprehensive and demanding. They are taking shape in our draft strategic plan for 2013 to 2020. I encourage you to peruse this wide-ranging document on our website and let us have your feedback. I urge you, as eminent alumni of New Zealand's leading university, always to remember your alma mater. We depend increasingly on our graduates for support, moral and political, as well as financial. This at a time when our country's universities receive the lowest income per student in the developed world. Your advocacy and influence are vital in encouraging government and the community at large to fund universities so they can generate the knowledge needed to drive a productive and competitive economy and to create full and satisfying lives for all New Zealanders. But that's enough from me on the challenges currently facing universities in New Zealand. For today is unquestionably your day. I warmly congratulate each and every one of you and trust that you will long cherish memories of your graduation in May 2012. I'm now very pleased to introduce our speaker this afternoon, Professor Sir Peter Gluckman. He is a former dean of our Faculty of Medical and Health Sciences, was the founding director of the Liggins Institute, and is one of New Zealand's best-known scientists. Sir Peter's research has won him numerous awards and international recognition, including fellowship of the Commonwealth's most prestigious scientific organisation, the Royal Society, London. He is the only New Zealander elected to the Institute of Medicine of the National Academies of Science in the USA and the Academy of Medical Sciences of Great Britain. In 2001, he received New Zealand's top science award, the Rutherford Medal. He was made a Knight of the New Zealand Order of Merit for services to medicine. 3 years ago, he was appointed as the first Chief Science Advisor to the Prime Minister of New Zealand. Sir Peter is an international advocate for science, promoting the translation of discoveries in biomedical research into improvements in long-term health outcomes. He is the author of over 500 scientific papers and reviews and editor of 8 books. Sir Peter.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of the university, graduands and family. Firstly, congratulations to all of today's graduands and diplomates. You should be deservedly proud of having graduated from New Zealand's highest ranked university and from a faculty that is distinguished internationally for its outstanding scholarship, research and teaching. Congratulations. Sometimes I'm asked whether science graduates have a future in New Zealand. I would turn that around and ask, does New Zealand have a future without science graduates such as yourselves? Certainly it would not. There's no challenge that we face as a nation over coming decades that does not depend on science in reaching a solution. It will be critical to our economic, our environmental, our social, and our cultural development. And this does not just mean science in the laboratory or science in the formal sense. Science has a critical role to play in the public dialogue as we develop a national consensus on how best to manage our economic growth to meet the societal aspirations of all, while at the same time protecting our fragile environment. To reach that consensus, we require a much more scientifically aware and literate population. Whether you develop your careers in science itself or use it as a stepping stone to another area of activity, your contribution to our society based on your experiences in this faculty, in this university, will be critical. So having graduated in science, it's perhaps worth reflecting on what is science. Science is not just a collection of facts. Rather, it is a particular way of understanding and observing the natural and built world so as to gain a better understanding of what it is. It's wrong to assume science is about certainty, for in most of science, certainty is not possible. It's largely about reducing uncertainty. As the great Nobel laureate and immunologist, the late Sir Peter Medawar, once put it, science is a means by which we analyse the many things that might be true about the universe and pare them down to the few that are probably true. I emphasise this because of the great issues we face. For example, how is the planet going to deal with 40% more people, all expecting and deserving a higher standard of living? This can only mean more use of the planet's finite resources. Yet, at the same time, there's also an increasing need to understand how to protect and conserve the fragile planet. There are also important issues that emerge as the very substrate of society moves from the physical to the virtual. The internet has created the problem of how to discern reliable from less reliable information and lead to a world smothered in information and polemic, leading to increasing confusion and indeed potentially loss of confidence in science as the key source of knowledge. But science, both formal and informal, remains the only process we have to gather information and understanding about our world on any scale and from any perspective. To reject this is to reject the very basis of logical assessment of the challenges we face. The one dimension of science that needs to be protected at all costs is the need for the collection and interpretation of data to be value-free. Such freedom from bias, as I'm sure you will have learnt already, is not easy. But science alone does not determine society. We thankfully do not live in a platonic society. Rather, we live in a participatory democracy that is underpinned by values that determine our priorities and trade-offs. But equally, when values dominate in the absence of science, decisions can be made on belief and dogma, and that can do us harm too. It's finding the right interplay between knowledge and values that makes society what it is. Technologies are developing faster all the time, and they're having far greater impact as they project so much more quickly. The challenge for society is to understand and accommodate these technologies at a pace commensurate with their development. Otherwise, some important technologies may be wrongly rejected, and yet others may be misused or their harm misunderstood. Indeed, this conflict between the pace of development and understanding by society can manifest in unfortunate ways. For example, in anti-scientism, an illogical but understandable response to the pace of change. Inevitably, therefore, well-trained science graduates such as yourselves are critical to a modern participatory democracy. We want you to participate. Indeed, you must. We need you not to just use your hard-earned degree to follow your aspirations, but also to use your knowledge of the scientific process and the understandings of science to participate in helping society navigate the challenges ahead. Universities are special places. Their roles of critics and consciences of society is enshrined in law and tradition. Often this has been assumed to be the role of your colleagues in other faculties, such as arts and law, but that obligation is equally so of you as science graduates. As graduates of this university, you are now members of this university's court of convocation. You remain as members of this university. In this new role, it is important that you play your role in protecting the contribution of scholarship on one hand to this nation's development, and participate, on the other hand, in the critical and public dialogue between knowledge and values that will be so essential as this society moves forward. Once again, congratulations to you all.
On your behalf, can I thank Sir Peter for his wise and interesting observations as our Chief Scientist. This is a meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for a ceremony of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. At this ceremony, the Pro-Chancellor, Dr. Ian Parton, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
Thank you, Chancellor. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within their faculty, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon an Associate Dean of the Faculty of Science, Mrs. Goldstone, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Science. Graduate Diploma in Science, Lewis Allen Anderson. Soumya Bhatnagar. Sina Masood Ansari. Barbara Jean Pike. Blake Andrew Watkins. Wei Mao Jing. To the degree of Bachelor of Optometry with First Class Honours. Jennifer Yi Chin Chi. Corrine Mary Fraser. Senior Scholar in Optometry. Yishin Gao. Aya Hardy. Michelle Elizabeth Jeffries. Senior Scholar in Optometry. Claire Elizabeth Ruani. Holun Roland Mack. Renita Maria Matis. Rahul Kumar Pama. Erna Fomi Rebecca Fotor Faamanayanga Takasawa. Erin Heather Tan. Benjamin Lewis Young. To the degree of Bachelor of Optometry with Second Class Honours First Division, Shruti Adlaka. Liu Chen. Kai Liang Chong. Marika Jane Foliotakis. Stephanie Melissa Fox, Min Ji Jia Kang, Rebecca Montero, Stephen Everett Mulcock, Cardigan Paramanthan Savisam, Sung Woo Park, Melody Ailing Shi, to the degree of Bachelor of Optometry with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Ruth Beverly Barton. Chu Fan Chen. Yan Ching Chen. Hai Yong Chong. Kyu Yong Han. Po Sik Lam. Robert John Ng. Yang Wang. Winnie Yun Wu. To the degree of Bachelor of Optometry, Rita Bishori. Olga Hammond. Yong Chen Shao. Teresa Cha Chi Tzu. Ranit Kumar Kapadia. So Young Kim. Jeff Shu Lee. Ka Wai Leong. Song Su Lim. Lucia Chi Ya Lin. David Anthony Sharrock. Nafisa Shlemenko. So Dam Song. Daphne Tulupi Tai. Vivian Wu Ching Wong. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Nural Issa Abdul Halim. Katie Ann Achilles. Scott Allen Agate. Seo Hee Ahn. Kadia Tahir Nasa Elkindi. Abdullah Al-Kasai. Tarek Aldieri. Amina Ali. Kashalia Vishnadakumra Amber Pattaya. Victor Hugh Carl Louis Magali Hoffman and Munston. David Ray Garland Apon. Kerry Amanda Atherley. Gemma Rosbin Augustine. Brianna Michelle Aziz, Raita Bakova, Charmaine Blanche Coache Badelis, Das Som Beck, Lewis Paul Bain, Cara Bainbridge, Claire Nicole Barker, Ethan David and Nisi Barraclough, Kent Marcus Batley, Olivia Isabel May Beatty, Michael Leroy Bevan, Hamangi Sobada Bana, Siddharth Bhattaya, Michelle Pamela Beer, Thomas Matthew Broderick, Emma Jane Bodley, Rushit Bunesh Bhattadra, Daniel Ross Bremner, Hilton Charles Bridger, Bernard Eric Bridges, Sinead Riona Brimacon, Christopher Peter Brinkman, Mark Anthony Brooks, Stephen Donald Brough, Ivan Thomas Bryce, Jessica Antoinette Birchall, Aaron Daniel Burl, Erica Ruth Burns, Jason Michael Burns, Philippa Claire Cameron, Matthew Thomas Campbell, Jeffrey Thomas Carr, Mathuri Chakravarti, Andrew Chan, Cassie Chan, Ho Ming Michael Chan, Ho Ming Ho Chan, Roseanne Kimberly Chan, Ting Fung Chan, Arlene Nalini Chandra, Chi Hao Chang, Huai Chang Chang, Xi Yun Chan, Thompson Yu Wei Chung, Philippa Ann Charlesworth, Chung Ching, Erin Wei Chen. Ken Ko Tao Chen. Zhang Chen. Wan Ting Cheng. Michael Chung. Tsi Young Stephanie Chung. Albert Chien Hong Chun. Yun Yong Choi. Pei Zhu Chao. Chuk Ying Chu. Michael Po Xiong Chung. Raymond Chung. Zara Messina Lena Clark. Matthew Kevin Clark. Samuel Kenneth Cabell Clive. Alexandru Servan Kolibaba. Nicola Rebecca Collins. Rebecca Gay Connolly. Elena Catherine Conahay. Matthew David Cornish. Christopher Luke Courteau. Sean William Crossan. Michael David Cunliffe. Rebecca Ann Cunliffe. Senior Scholar Science, Sarah Michelle Dakin. Hayden Colin Davison. Laura Rose Dawson. Kishara Naletti De Silva. Ella Rachel Francis Denae. Simadeep Kaur Dillon. Lynn Ding. Wen Ding. Rachel Claire Dodd. Siobhan Kelly Drew. Karina Elizabeth Ann D'Souza. Richard Michael Duggan. Samuel Charles Eady. Samantha Jane Edwards. Hannah Marie Aldi. Tyler James Elliott. Emma Frances Fenstra. Laurel Trillium Leonard Field. Stephanie Rachel Field. David Benjamin Finley. Jackson Gregory Finley. Anthony Robert Fisk. James David Fleet. Kelly Fletcher, Maria Lavaglia Ross Fortuno, yeah. Santha Elizabeth France, yeah. Michael J. Freeman, Senior Scholar Science Rupert Charles Freeman. Dylan Fry, Isha Gangotra, Kerry Tan Garlick, Caleb John Gaston, Faraz Gussie. Theo Clifton Gibbons, Luke Fraser Gibson, Megan Catherine Gilbert, Sarah Frances Gleason, Kenny Bogong, Laura Robin Gowdy, Alexandra Emily Green, Sasha Yuman Courtney Green, Sir, the Associate Dean of Faculty of Science, Dr. Brennan, will present further graduates in the Faculty of Science.
To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with First Class Honours, James Howden Daniel. Rihanna Jackson. Shelley Lowe. To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with Second Class Honours, First Division, Sean Sien Jin Liu. Arti Prashant Patel. Seung Jae Ryu. Isha Sharma. To the degree of Bachelor of Technology with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Simon Andrew Ashforth. Aaron Manohar Vajendla. Dong Hyun Yi. Yi Hui Sheng. To the degree of Bachelor of Technology, Bin Lin. Wuyan Woon. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Conjoint, Zachary Norton Freearden and a Bachelor of Arts. Chung Kyu Jonas Chan and a Bachelor of Arts. Samantha Kate Chapman and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kathleen Jessica Collier and a Bachelor of Arts. Salome Damley and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Science, Kyle David Folster and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sarah Joy Fife and a Bachelor of Arts. Yeah. Charlotte Edith Joan Gobbez and a Bachelor of Commerce. Kimberly Jane Hayter and a Bachelor of Arts. Michael Helm and a Bachelor of Commerce. Senior Scholar Science, Michael James Hoskins and a Bachelor of Commerce. Robin William Kelly and a Bachelor of Music. Senior Scholar Arts and Senior Scholar Science, Joshua Eric Christensen Totten. And that's with a Bachelor of Arts. Yakin Liu and a Bachelor of Commerce. Catherine Ann Longstaff and a Bachelor of Arts. Samuel William McEwen and a Bachelor of Commerce. Joshua Anthony Montero and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alicia Magdalene Ollie and a Bachelor of Arts. Rebecca Grace Pearman and a Bachelor of Arts. Ashley Josephine Robbins and a Bachelor of Arts. Samantha Ann Stronger and a Bachelor of Arts. Leilani Aria Visitakul Walker and a Bachelor of Arts. Andrew John Wilson and a Bachelor of Arts. Chi Su and a Bachelor of Commerce.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Yoon B.G. on cello, accompanied by Kent Isamura on piano, will now perform Cantabile by Niccolo Paganini. Thank you. Of course, it's a famous and much-loved piece of music, but one never tires of hearing it played when it's played so beautifully. Can I ask you to show your appreciation again to Ewan Kent? Each year we have memorable performances such as the one you've just heard by students from our School of Music here at graduation. All graduands and families who would like to hear further performances of that calibre are invited to the graduation concert at 7:30 p.m. this Saturday in the Town Hall. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Roger France, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Science, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor Guildford, to present further graduands in that faculty.
Postgrad Diploma in Applied Psychology, Joanne Constant Windquist. Postgraduate Diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with Distinction, Alexander William Franklin Smith. Postgraduate Diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with Merit, Laura Daisy Jones. Postgraduate Diploma in Bioscience Enterprise, Rakesh Rajiv. Postgraduate Diploma in Forensic Science with Distinction, Rory Christopher Gardner. Tracy Lynn Haldane. University Graduate Scholar, Janine Michaela Watson. Postgraduate Diploma in Forensic Science with Merit, Shimmain Fleur Satur. Postgraduate Diploma in Forensic Science, Constance Wee Jaya. Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Distinction, A University Graduate Scholar, Esther Elizabeth Dale in Biosecurity and Conservation. Annette Elizabeth Evans in Biosecurity and Conservation. Anna Kate Farquhar in Wine Science. Tobias Callan Francis in Geology. Tina Kathagay Janara Bandara Gumagay in Biomedical Science. Olivia Nicole Patricia Hamilton in Biological Sciences. James Yao Ming Lei in Biological Sciences. Swastika Lal in Marine Science. Donald Scott McKenzie in Biosecurity and Conservation. Kai Nain Mint in Biomedical Science. Dobashini Pushpa Newman in Biological Sciences. Katie Jane Parrish in Wine Science. Peter David Radonich in Mathematics. Susan Mary Sinclair in Biosecurity and Conservation. Jamie Reagan Stavert in Biosecurity and Conservation. Zoe Lee Stone in Biosecurity and Conservation. Lara Bernadette Taylor in Environmental Management. Postgraduate Diploma in Science with Merit, Yotika Kashal Ali in Food Science. Anne-Marie Malbar in Psychology. Anna-Marie Bayer in Environmental Science. Erin Marie Berry in Environmental Management. Marguerite Gay Muriel Bihasa in Environmental Science. Chi Yi Chin in Cardiac Rehabilitation. Un Cho Choi in Chemistry and a Bachelor of Science. Tian Ying Chu in Statistics. Dylan Thomas Clark in Environmental Science. Prabir Aloysius Courier in Environmental Science. Kerry Lee De Villiers in Biological Sciences. Yvette Elizabeth Hodgson in Geography. Judy Ying Chi Hu in Wine Science and a Bachelor of Science. Robin Louise Kennermayer in Environmental Science. Hu Min Lin in Environmental Science. Janine Melissa Martin in Environmental Science. William Ian Millen in Geographic Information Science. Eileen Rachel Nolan Walker in Biosecurity and Conservation. Andrew Rees Pugh in Biosecurity and Conservation. Stephanie Laura Rowe in Wine Science. Ellen Emmeline van der Wey in Speech Science. Postgraduate Diploma in Science. Rekati Sulakashana Abhyaya Waradana in Biomedical Science. Thierry Zolvida Abrigo in Environmental Science. Ahmed Al Salim in Environmental Science. Omion John Arabash Shahi in Chemistry. Weem Samir Obanja in Chemistry. Miles Anthony Bruce in Chemistry. Umamaheswari Chidambaram in food science. Carl Wayne Dalton in geology. Yu Wa Dong in environmental science. Jeffrey Ernest Sakar in food science. Matthew Stanley Ryan Freeman in physics. Rowan Guy Freeman in environmental science. Adriana Marcela Garcia Carrillo in environmental science. Alan Goldie Henry in environmental management and a graduate diploma in science. Shiara Jagru in geographic information science. Sao Ji in statistics. Oliver Dominic Rove Kent in environmental management and a Bachelor of Science. Akuthan Kumara Vet Pillai in computer science. Alex Liu in geographic information science. Payam Pahude in biological sciences. Gemma Marie Ann Phillips in applied mathematics and a Bachelor of Science. Andrea Carmen Pile in biological sciences. Amruta Miland Renard in biological sciences. Kenneth Hansa Runasinger Achige in food science. Sonia Sharma in biological sciences. Ida Dagny Simpson in environmental science. Murray Albert Smith in psychology. Ryan Nicholas Smith in geography. Siamalan Subramanian in wine science. Sonia Thakrar in biomedical science and a Bachelor of Science. Monisha Bibhuti Thakur in environmental management. Tunjo Tseng in chemistry. Ari Jamedti Turkestani in pharmacology. Fan Wang in computer science. Alistair Ian Watts in applied mathematics and a Bachelor of Science. Yudi Zhao in biomedical science. Yu Zhao in statistics. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with First Class Honours, William Joel Mitchell Adam in chemistry. Peter William Akers in chemistry. Yeah. Sunja Badranar Yanan in medicinal chemistry and a Bachelor of Science. Senior Scholar in Computer Science, Joshua Andrew Bax in Mathematics and a Bachelor of Science. Pieta Amber Brown in Statistics and a Bachelor of Laws and a Bachelor of Science conjoint. University Graduate Scholar Octavia Ellen Jean Laura Caldador in Psychology. Dion James Chaligoy in Biomedical Sciences. Senior Scholar in Science, University Graduate Scholar Sean Neil Curry in Mathematics and a Bachelor of Science. Oscar Edward Thomas Eaton in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. Yuthika Gurme in Psychology. Emma Christina Rata Gullery in Statistics. Jungmin Han in Applied Mathematics. Sarah Olivia Catherine Hensby Bennett in Biomedical Sciences. Yufeng Hao in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. Amadeus D. Huang in Biomedical Science. Igor Alexandrovich Yanovsky in Logic and Computation. University Graduate Scholar, Senior Scholar, Biological Sciences, Renee Bronwyn Johansson in Biological Sciences. Emily Jane Keesing Stiles in Chemistry. Jun Cheong Siu Kwan in Statistics. Shuki Lam in Food Science. Amber Denise McClelland in Psychology. Lee McDonald in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. Stuart Michael McGill in Psychology. Sarah Elizabeth McRae in Biological Sciences. Helen May Munro in Geography. Ruanui Vincent Nicholson in Mathematics. University Graduate Scholar Sotaro Ochiai in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. Lekambage Lakshika Chaitini Pereira in Chemistry. Jean Co Quick in Psychology. University Graduate Scholar, Senior Scholar Applied Mathematics, Martin Luke Rennie in Biomedical Sciences and a Bachelor of Science. Junru Song in Biomedical Science. Rebecca Marie Turner in Biological Sciences. Angela Wu in Biomedical Science. Annie Shuping Yang in Biomedical Science. Ho Young in Medicinal Chemistry. Jingjing Zhang in Biological Sciences. Zhu Zhang in Biomedical Science and a Bachelor of Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Layla Amira Aziz in Statistics. Aiko Rafa Safri in Medicinal Chemistry. Chaplin Chan in Geography. Hugo Kaho Fong in Chemistry. Shannon Miles Hecker in Applied Mathematics. David Sejong Huang in Computer Science. Xuan Jiang in Computer Science. Cornelia Marion Rukshana Martin Austin in Geography and a Bachelor of Arts and a Bachelor of Science conjoint. Lisa Michelle Nielsen in Psychology. Mary Joyce Bernadette Soriano Ramos in Sport and Exercise Science. Natalie Josephine Strathan Wood in Geography and a Bachelor of Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Jessica Elizabeth McLean in Statistics and a Bachelor of Science. To the degree of Master of Science, Speech Language Therapy Practice with First Class Honours, Brooklyn May Davis. Richard Duncan Key. University Graduate Scholar, Bridget Helen Thompson. To the degree of Master of Speech Language Therapy Practice with Second Class Honours, First Division, Amy Elizabeth Allen. Rosanna Elizabeth Dixon. Sarah Natasha Hermans. Courtney Jane Parrish. Rebecca Mary Patterson. Marion Diana Van Nierop. To the degree of Master of Speech Language Therapy Practice with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Sarah Frances Ellis Garston. Carolyn Yench. Kirsty Jane Tweedale. To the degree of Master of Speech Language Therapy Practice, Jessica Amanda May.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Clinical Psychology, Hamish Douglas Mackenzie Bartle University Doctoral Scholar. Hamish investigated the motives and supports for desistance from further offending in men who had received treatment related to sexual offending against children with a view to improving rehabilitation efforts. Annabelle Elizabeth Clark, University Doctoral Scholar. Annabelle developed and trialled a new education-based intervention to reduce fatigue after stroke, with a view to determining if participants would accept the intervention and if it was likely to be of clinical benefit. Alexandra Louise Haynes, University Doctoral Scholar. Alex investigated the effectiveness of brief mindfulness training for socially anxious adults. Her findings support the use of mindfulness training in psychological treatments for social anxiety. Apola Julia Ioane. Julia investigated the social, demographic, educational characteristics and offending behaviour of Pacific Island youths who offend violently and compared them with those of Māori and Palangi violent youth offenders. This research is likely to provide us with a greater understanding of this challenging demographic and inform the way that we work with Pacific Island youth and their families. Tina Kulikova, University Doctoral Scholar. Tina investigated recognition memory and electrophysiological processes linked with memory formation in healthy elder adults, with a view to developing a protocol capable of identifying the earlier stages of Alzheimer's disease. Penny Jane Mansell, University Doctoral Scholar. Penny investigated young adult stepchildren's experiences of relationships with stepmothers. She aimed to gain the perspective of stepchildren on those experiences that contributed to a positive stepmother-stepchild relationship, and those experiences that were difficult and hindered the development of the relationship. She also examined the relationship in terms of its development over time. Sarah Jane McNeil, University Doctoral Scholar. Sarah examined the central role attachment and security plays in exacerbating reactions to stressful life events such as symptoms of depression. Her research has important implications for understanding and counteracting people's vulnerabilities to depression when facing daily stress and more substantial life difficulties. Casey Alexandra Mendiola. Casey examined the impact on Māori whānau of their children's deliberate self-harm, their beliefs about the reasons for such acts, and their treatment needs, with a view to enhancing treatment provision for such families within mental health services. Matthew John Shepherd. Matt investigated the design of a computerised cognitive behavioural therapy program, SPARKS, and evaluated its effectiveness for Māori adolescents by conducting focus groups in a small pilot study. He also analysed the Māori participant data from a large randomised control trial. The findings indicate that CCBT can be equally effective as the treatment Māori young people currently receive for treatment of mild to moderate depression. Julia Maria Somerville, University Doctoral Scholar. Julia focused on how a nationwide youth development program selects participants, and in particular how decisions are made to exclude potential participants with specified risk behaviours. She also looked at opportunities for supporting young people who are currently excluded. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Suzanne Jennifer Ackerley in Sport and Exercise Science. Suzanne explored novel methods for promoting brain plasticity and motor learning after stroke. Her findings were recognised by the American Heart and Stroke Association as one of the top 25 advances in brain recovery and rehabilitation in 2010. Hetty Afememonga in Operations Research. Hetty studied the effects of simple model balancing of the costs of private versus public transportation. Numerical results showed that giving individuals information about the current state of the system may sometimes lead to considerable improvements in performance and reduced delays. Rachel Vanita Blagojevic in Computer Science, University Doctoral Scholar, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Rachel investigated the use of data mining techniques for construction of digital ink recognisers. She developed new recognisers which could accurately discriminate between drawing and writing ink. Rachel. Lindley Valmay Bradnam in Sport and Exercise Science. Lindley showed that non-invasive brain stimulation techniques of the non-stroke hemisphere could be used to improve control of the affected arm in patients with mild impairment after stroke. Based on her novel model of upper limb control after stroke, she hypothesised and demonstrated that the same technique may degrade control of the parietic arm in patients with more severe impairment, reminding us that brain stimulation is not a one-size-fits-all approach. Jonathan Francis Briggs in Statistics, University Doctoral Scholar. Jonathan developed statistical methods for estimating the uncertainty in predictions from large spatial models like weather forecasting and climate models. Emma Louise Carroll in Biological Sciences. Emma used genetic monitoring to investigate the recovery and population structure of the New Zealand southern right whale. This work showed that the New Zealand population is distinct to the Australian populations and that whales from the remnant calving grounds near the Auckland Islands are slowly recolonising former calving grounds around mainland New Zealand. Jason Kevin Gurney in Sport and Exercise Science. Jason investigated the effect of a low-impact balance and lower limb strength training intervention on the sensory and motor complications of peripheral nerve damage in patients with diabetes. He found that increased sensory function was possible with low-impact training without the increased risk of plantar ulceration due to the repetitive tissue loading found in aerobic exercise training. Emily Page Harvey in Mathematics, University Doctoral Scholar, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Emily investigated the mechanisms underlying oscillations of calcium in mathematical models of various cell types. These oscillations are known to act as signals in almost all cell types, and an understanding of the mechanisms controlling the oscillations is of fundamental importance in cell physiology. Kristen Marie Henty in Biological Sciences, University Doctoral Scholar. Kristen investigated the mechanism of action of neuroglobin and showed how this brain-associated protein could intervene in the process of programmed cell death, which is associated with stroke, Alzheimer's disease, and some forms of blindness. Kristen's results have allowed the rational design of a number of potential drug treatments for these common, lethal, and debilitating conditions. Christian Joachim Hirsch in computer science. Christian explored the concept of the visual wiki, which combines the notions of textual and visual representations of information, either of which may be editable in a collaborative way. He designed and implemented four example visual wiki applications, which he then generalized into a visual wiki meta tool that permits rapid specification and implementation of visual wiki applications, and which is currently under commercial development. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma.
On behalf of the university, I now invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. This would be an ideal opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori and then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programs.
to be able to work with communities, low decile schools, in a way that will make a difference to them, and we're able to contribute to their dreams.